Stanley Golovac here at Space Coast Surgery Center. Today we're going to be performing what's called a ganglion of Impar block on an individual who has a condition called coccydynia. This is a procedure that's done to help interrupt the pain fibers located in the lower sacral segments of S1, S2, and S3, and S4. With that, we should be able to alleviate a significant portion of her pain and hopefully gain knowledge as to where the etiology of the pain is coming from. So we'll continue on by showing you exactly how the procedure is done under fluoroscopic guidance. We're going to be using some contrast and then a local anesthetic with a steroid to help alleviate the swelling and inflammation from the procedure. All right? Here we go. By doing a ganglion of Impar, we're going to first identify the sacral coccygial junction, which we're going to anesthetize first. So mosquito, mosquito, sting, sting, burn, burn, here we go. And after initially anesthetizing the skin, the subcutaneous tissue, we're going to allow the anesthetic to work and then use an angulated 25 gauge spinal needle to get underneath the sacral coccygial junction. Once there, we'll go ahead and inject the contrast medium of non-ionic medium, being isobute number 200M, which is a myelographic component of contrast. Once we see the structure visually enhancing the area below the sacral coccygeal ligament, we'll then go ahead and inject the anesthetic, which is a combination of neuropin and decadron. So here we go, needle placement, small pressure, and localizing itself underneath the fluoroscope. We want to make sure we get right underneath the sacral coccygeal junction. Once again, fluoro. Once again, fluoro. And now that we can see the position is right underneath, we'll go ahead and inject the contrast. This should enhance itself. And here we go under live fluoro. We can see the contrast itself formulating underneath the sacral coccygeal junction. And now we'll go ahead and inject the anesthetic. So we'll save that image and complement the area with medication. We'll go ahead and get an AP now to show and confirm that the placement of the needle remains in the midline. And we can see that it's underneath the sacrum. And there's our picture, and our component lies midline where the symphysis pubis and the ramus that you can see in the inferior margin of the screen. Procedure is now complete, and we'll go ahead and remove the needle from the actual site itself.